Foam jellies are awesome for so many reasons. They're mesmerizing, they're beautiful, they're graceful, but we don't know very much about them. People have been trying to culture comb jellies here for decades and with very limited success, and I got obsessed. I worked on it for 8 months trying different life support setups, different temperatures, different salinities, different food items, and we did just discover that they only reproduce if they're being fed well. And for the comb jellies that we've bred, it's feeding them larval fish. And that was a really exciting discovery. That's reason number one why they're difficult to breed. Reason number two is their fertilized embryos are super tiny. Most jellies go through a polyp phase, but comb jellies do not have a polyp phase because they're both female and male at the same time. So they just spawn and have fertilized embryos floating in the water. And I think people probably didn't know what they were looking at. I certainly didn't the first couple of times I did it. I really couldn't believe it. I'd look into my little box I was growing the comb jellies in, and there they were. And that definitely fueled the passion, for sure. One thing that really stands out to me is the way that they move. Comb jellies actually don't pulse like most jellies. They use cilia for locomotion. Cilia is a hair-like projection, and in fact, when you're looking at the comb jellies on exhibit, you're actually seeing them diffract light. You're not actually seeing light produced from the animal. We put high-powered lights on our exhibits to illuminate them, and the cilia brilliantly catches that light in that rainbow pattern. But they do actually produce their own light as well. They are bioluminescent animals, which is really awesome. I'm really proud of the whole jelly team because we've been doing great work with these comb jellies, and I really hope that it catches on. There's a comb jelly craze.